I picked 4 phones from Samsung, Galaxy, Sony, Xperia and Google Pixel to compare the battery life, performance and camera to see which is the best mid-range phone. You probably noticed there is no Chinese brand here, there's really no reason for it, other than I don't have any in my drawer. Also, all of the chipsets of these phones are being produced in Samsung Foundry, which makes the comparison even more interesting. From left to right, we have Xperia 10 Mark 6, the last generation, which was Xperia 10 Mark 5, had the best battery ever, and we will see if this year lives to the last generation. It has a headphone jack with a great sound quality, the downside of the phone is 60Hz display and rather a weak processor, which is a Snapdragon 6th generation one. The second is the Pixel 8a, the camera on this phone is amazing, and the processor, which is Tensor G3, is powerful for a mid-range smartphone. But it is not efficient and we will see how it holds up in the test. Then we have A55, which is a great all-rounder. This is a phone I would suggest to anyone that just want to have an Android phone. The battery is decent, the camera is decent, nothing to complain about, and it is running on Exynos 1480. Then we have the cheaper brother, the A35, running on the last generation of Exynos 1380. It is basically doing everything the A55 does, but just slightly more on a budget. I used the lux meter to put all phones on 750 nits. When I was doing it, I kinda felt the panel of the Pixel 8a is not as good as the rest of the pack, but it's just my subjective feeling. Also seems like Xperia 10 Mark 6 has the sharpest display, which makes sense since the resolution is the same as the rest, but the phone has a higher pixel density. All 4 phones are connected to the same 5G network. For this test, I'm gonna turn the Wi-Fi off except for when I'm doing the benchmarking. For the first test, I decided to run YouTube shorts on 5G on all phones for around 50 minutes. You can also see that I'm using the battery widget I wrote and I didn't find time to publish it yet. From top to bottom, I'm showing battery percentage, temperature in Celsius, and temperature in Fahrenheit. By the end of this part, Xperia has 95% left at 35 degrees Celsius, Pixel 8a has 93% left at 37 degrees Celsius, A55 had 93% left at 34 degrees Celsius, and A35 had 93% left too with 34 degrees Celsius. A55 stayed the coolest, while the Xperia 10 Mark 6 used the least amount of battery. Then I did a similar thing, but this time I filmed using the front-facing camera. One thing I noticed is that the only camera that does not support 4K with the front-facing camera is Xperia, while others do support 4K with the selfie cam. Also, Xperia 1 Mark 6 showed some latency, which was a bit strange because the connection in my home is actually decent and all phones are connected to the same network. It's been 1 hour and I measured the body temperature of the phones and they all had similar temperature, but the battery temperature is again high on Pixel and Xperia, while it's better on the Samsung phones. It is worth noting that Snapdragon 6th generation one, which is used by Xperia, is made in a Samsung foundry and is not very well known for having a high yield or being efficient, so it kind of explains the heat, even though on paper it should stay cooler than the other phones. I didn't have heating issues with Xperia 10 Mark 5 for the reference. On the other hand, I should say smaller phones tend to get hotter compared to larger phones because of the laws of thermodynamics. By the end of the test, at 1 hour and 30 minutes, Xperia had 86% battery left, while Pixel 83, A55 84 and A35 also 84% left. Pixel got really hot to 42 degrees Celsius, Xperia is 1 degree behind and A55 was again the coolest, even though the Exynos 1480 is the most powerful chipset in the batch. Xperia is 1 degree behind and A55 was again the coolest. I then decided to run 2 sets of benchmarks, AnTuTu for testing the phones in general and 3D Mark for GPU. AnTuTu is my favorite benchmark because it basically tests everything. I know a lot of folks say benchmarks are not always very representative of real life, but frankly to me AnTuTu replicates normal users quite well and the result is rather accurate. The test ended with Xperia getting 517k, Pixel 8a getting the best score of 752k, close to it was A55 with a score of 723k, and A35 with a score of 596k. I should note, usually the phones get slightly higher scores, but it's summer now, so they are a bit hot, so it affects the score. Also, it's good to note that in terms of CPU performance, the A55 did the best, followed by the A35, then the Xperia, and finally Pixel 8a. In terms of GPU, Pixel 8a did much better, which is because Tensor needs all of those powerful AI stuff and computational photography, followed by A55, A35, and Xperia did very poorly. Then I ran the Wildlife Extreme test to test the performance of the GPU. Xperia was again last with 608, followed by A35 with 799, A55 with 10,033, and finally Pixel 8a with 2,434. But Pixel 8a was not as stable in result while the rest were, because they didn't got hot, which is natural as they're not as power hungry as Pixel 8a. The thing is, Pixel 8a is actually using a semi-flagship chipset, while the others are using either old flagship chipset or mid-range Exynos. To stress test the phones, I ran Google Miss on 5G. From my experience, Google Miss 5G really pushes the phones to their limits, and this is where you can check the thermal throttling of the phones. As we've seen already, Pixel 8a is the one again that passes the 40 degrees Celsius or 110 degrees Fahrenheit first, followed by Xperia 10 Mark 6. I pushed the phones further to see what the temperature heat maps look like, and if we look at the surface temperature, the Pixel 8a is hot all over the place, while Xperia 1 Mark 6 and others are only hot on top. Also, Xperia's maximum body temperature is higher than Pixel 8a, even though the battery temperature is lower. By the end of the test, Pixel 8a got to a scary hot levels of 48.6 degrees Celsius, which is 119 Fahrenheit, while Xperia 10 Mark 6 got to 44 and 111 Fahrenheit, and A35 barely got to 40, which is 104 Fahrenheit. And the coolest was A55 is only 38 degrees Celsius and 101 Fahrenheit. Whatever Samsung is doing with this Exynos should be done on S24 Exynos 2. I kindly asked their departments to talk to each other. I turned all their phones off, went to sleep, and left them on 5G to test the standby. After around 12 hours, Xperia lost 3%, Pixel 8a lost 7%, A55 6%, and A35 7%. I then went out for a walk outside for 2 hours next, did turn on the GPS first though, with an app called ADAS Running, which disclaimer I'm a product manager of, and took some pictures. By the time I was back, Pixel 8a only had 17% left, Xperia 10 Mark 6 had the most amount of battery with 41% left. Now let's take a look at the pictures that I took. Both Samsung phones have a macro lens, while the other two don't, but in my experience, the macro mode on mid-range phones is not better than the normal camera with computational photography. Here you can see all four phones did a very similar job. The picture on Xperia 10 Mark 6 is a bit more saturated and sharper. On the zoom level, it is really hard to distinguish between the pictures. They all did a great job, maybe just A35 is a bit noisier than the rest, and the same is the main lens on the cameras. Pixel 8a is a bit brighter, but the pictures on Xperia and Samsung look very similar. By the way, I'm sorry if the phones are not showing as crisp, I forgot to shoot on 4K. From my perspective, the test is done, but I just wanted to drain the batteries to zero, so I just ran some YouTube. It's quite obvious at this point that Pixel 8a with a smaller battery is going to die first, and most likely Xperia 10 Mark 6 is gonna win the battery battle. From my experience, the A35 and A55 usually have a very similar battery, but for some reasons in this test, the A55 is leading by a big margin. By the way, the stopwatch was restarted at night, so we should add 3 hours and 2 minutes to the time. Therefore, after 7 hours and 40 minutes, Pixel 8a left the chat. I would say it is still an impressive screen on time or SOT. The next one was A35 with 5000 mAh battery and Exynos 1380, which left the chat at 7 hours and 36 minutes. The second place was earned by Galaxy A55, which lasted 8 hours and 30 minutes, which is quite a good performance, especially since the chipset is powerful enough for a mid-range phone. Not to mention the thermal performance was amazing during the test. Xperia fought very well and kept going, and finally we have Xperia 1 Mark 6, the king of battery life. It seems Sony is pushing for this battery life performance. A bit of a shame that their thermal performance wasn't on par with Xperia 1 Mark 6 or Xperia 10 Mark 5, but it's because of a Snapdragon 6 Generation 1, which is known for its poor thermals. The battery lasted for 9 hours and 34 minutes, which completely blew the rest of the competition. To recap, Pixel 8a has a great camera system and computational photography. The chipset is the most powerful, but the thermals were poor and the battery life was last. Then we have the A35, which came third. The chipset is not the greatest, but does the job. It's a good all-rounder, especially for places where the A55 is not available, like the USA. The second place was A55, which does well in almost all aspects, and the thermal management is phenomenal. I think after Xperia 1 Mark 6, it is the best thermal management I've seen on a phone in 2024. And we have the winner of the battery life of non-Chinese mid-range phones, that is the Xperia 10 Mark 6. From my perspective, it's a good phone, but it doesn't have the best performance. It has a headphone jack, which is great if you have a Sennheiser like me, or anything wired and you want to listen to music. It's also a compact size. I did a very similar comparison of the same brands but their compact flagships, which you can see next in the video that is popping right now. Thanks for tuning into Techmo, and I will see you in the next one.